We are a project management company, consulting company for this World Bank SBI funding, this lending project. So for this, we have recommended some of the business models which for to the Forum of Regulators in India. And so today I would like to take you through those things. So so there's an overview of the solar rooftops sector in India. I think most of you must be aware about this. So we have close to 5.2 gigawatts installed capacity as on September 2017, and under this recently the MNRE has given a target for close to 40 gigawatts, which it needs to be completed by 2022. And for the last financial year, we 1.8 gigawatts has been added to the capacities. And this is a breakup of sector wise as well as the business model. So you can see the major chunk is by the industrial and commercial and public sector units. And coming to the business model, still the capex remains the most popular form of business project development, and remaining is RESCO. And coming to the leading solar installations in the states, Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu, Rajasthan, and Gujarat are leading the rooftop installations in India. And these are the key project developers and the key EPC players who are active in Indian market. So here I would like to give a glimpse about the recently launched the phase 2 program by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. And so because earlier the state nodal agencies used to handle the all approval process, and so they are the front end companies in giving the interconnections and everything. And so right now, because the rooftop is not going as expected, so because of gigantic targets of 40 gigawatts, so now the DISCOMs has been brought to the forefront, and these are the key objectives where the ministry came out to the forefront, just to promote the grid-connected rooftop PV in the all consumer segments, to bring DISCOMs as a key drivers for rapid deployment of GRPV, and to create awareness, capacity building, human resource development, to promote sustainable business models, to create additional capacity of 38 gigawatts by 2022, and to promote the domestic manufacturing of solar cells and modules. And so today I'm speaking actually about the DISCOMs, but we don't have any, I don't think anyone from the DISCOMs right here. So why, because from DISCOMs perspective, like why, because currently we feel the DISCOM is not supporting as expected. So, but still they need to think about it, because anyway, the solar is here to stay. And so these are some of the questions which the DISCOMs has to think about it, like why should why rooftop solar, and what are the benefits of adoption, and what are the grid integration challenges, and which kind of business model will be suitable for the Indian markets, and what should be the implementation roadmap for the capacity allocated to the each states. Actually, MNRE allocates capacities to each and every states depending on the potential which has been calculated, and how to reduce the administrative overheads of all individual by simplifying the processes, organization structure, and all these things. And so this is more which are in vogue, like this is the capex model, how it works and all these things. So I think which everyone are aware about it, like so it is where the consumer will be having an EPC agreement with the EPC company, and he sells the power, and whatever excess will be injected to the DISCOM, and if he has taken a debt component from any bank, so that is how that installments he'll be paying. So this is the capex model which is currently is there. And this is the RESCO model. where Resco will be investing in the asset, and there and owning the solar PV, and the consumer will be paying the predetermined tariff to the Resco. And these are the other new innovative business models which we have suggested to the Forum of Regulators, where we wanted the DISCOM to aggregate so that the transaction cost and it will be reduced, and so that the economies of scale will come into play. And this is how it is, there will be EC EPC frame where the DISCOM will be having this kind of arrangement. And they will go for a reverse bidding so that good price can be determined. And in that one, it is a DISCOM will aggregate and acts as an EPC as well. But so in that one also, it's almost similar, but it will be having a EPC agreement back to back with the EPC firm, so that this is basically for the security point of view. This is for the DISCOM aggregates, and there will be a third party which acts as a RESCO. So here also similar almost, but here it is owned by the consumer, and DISCOM also will be having a back-to-back PPAs where there will be a few power supply agreements with the consumer and PPA with the RESCO with the predetermined tariffs. And these are the benefits. So these are the key benefits, where the revenue from the facilitation fee will be paid to the RESCO firms, and there will be a low risk profile, because I think the financing is a big issue for the rooftop projects currently. And obviously it will lower the transaction cost for the developers, because DISCOM is aggregating the market. And this is one more example from the state of Andhra Pradesh, which they have tried on pilot mode for the city of Visakhapatnam. So this is basically from the Andhra Bank, particularly targeted to those consumers who are consuming up to 200 units of energy per month. And here the DISCOM will be anchoring this model, and it is like an on-bill financing. So depending on the utility bill, this is for the 1 kilowatt systems, and EMI will be added to the electricity bill, and so that the EPC contractor will be having the payment security. So this is specifically targeted for the residential consumers. So this is on pilot mode, which has approved by the APERC recently. So this is similar models which we have discussed earlier. So this is for the Kerala utility owned model, also the demand aggregation model. So Kerala has given the three different options to the consumers of the Kerala, which is a lease model, where the KSAB itself will bear the cost and the operation maintenance, and the RESCO cost will be bared by the RESCO companies. And in that, the 10% of the electricity will be given to the consumers on free of cost. In the scheme two, the consumer will be paying the tariff for whatever generation by adding his trading margin. In the third one, it is that DISCOM will facilitate this one. So consumer will be owning the cost. He will put his money, and RESCO will bear the installation cost and all these things. And consumer can sell the partial or entire energy, whatever being produced at the fixed tariff. So these are the key challenges being faced by entire rooftop fraternity, I think, which everyone will be knowing, like the limited availability of financing, especially the smaller consumers and SMSME, so because of lower credit ratings. And collateral security for small enterprises and residential consumers, which they are not ready to give any collaterals for such a small projects. And limited legal recourses in cases where contracts are not dishonored. And what we have seen in Maharashtra, similarly, there are frequent changes in the policy which is happening, like net billing, net metering, and gross metering. So this kind of uncertainty will be difficult for the EPC companies. and capacity constraints. Yeah. So there are some various loading levels in different states. Like in some states they allow up to 80%, in some states it is up to 100% capacity of the transformer. And coming to the approval process, still the approval process are still like this is about like CEIGs or interconnection processes and all, which is still cumbersome. It takes it is varying from state to state. Yeah. And coming to the financing options, so World Bank SBI has got a long-term concessional loan of $648 million. So basically, it has reduced the cost of capital. I think they are giving at around 8%. And also ADB and PNB also has a line of credit. And other banks are giving the financing based on this home improvement loans, like Canara Bank, Sind Bank has the products. Still, we are in talks with other banks also to come out with similar loans. Yeah, thank you. That's it.